So we're running a mental health program, and we're acting as a display model for food production, organic urban food production. So we're open to members of the public to come and see, and we sell some stuff to them, but we'd rather just sort of sell them seedlings or inspire them to grow their own rather than take our food. But we do always sell some stuff to the public. But yeah, as an educational model and as a mental health program, those are our two things.
Julie, how long have you been going?
Well, the garden has been a community-focused garden for 30 years. Prior to that, it was being looked after by a group of nuns who lived here and farmed the land. And they sold it to the council, Auckland Council, who now lease it out to an organisation called Kelmarna Gardens Trust, and they've been here for 12 years. And Framework has been here for 12 years, which is the organisation that Adrian and I work for, which is the mental health side of our work.
So what, Adrian, mental health, how does a garden relate to that?
I guess it's in the vein of gardening is good for everyone, no matter where you are on the mental health continuum. It's just a... So we're here gardening together, learning together, eating the food together, hanging out, maybe talking about our stuff along the way. So it's just being in this environment together, and whatever comes out of that, comes out of that. I mean, it's a little bit more formal than that, but probably in reality it's at that sort of casual level. Just the stuff happens from being here in this beautiful place together.
Yeah, and Julie, we've just had lunch with 15 of you.
Yeah.
And can you describe, say, how people contribute? Because they've all got their own patch, haven't they?
Yeah.
The women in the background and the man we can see there, they've got their own patch.
Yeah. Well, people contribute either by harvesting the produce that's out of their garden and providing that to the table, or actually getting in there and physically sort of creating the recipe, whether like today it was pumpkin soup, or on other days, because we've got chickens here, we sometimes do, you know, a lot of things around eggs and omelets and stuff. So people contribute A, by growing the produce and then helping prepare it, and sharing in the spirit of the preparation and the celebration of that food, I think, is a huge thing for people. It's hugely successful for people to actually eat what they've grown. You know, it gives them a sense of pride.
And what's the process of decision making as to who grows what? A long one.
Well, it's a sort of a chaos, but I mean,
organised chaos.
Yeah, it's like there's sort of like 30 home gardens here, but then we do have some bigger plots where we might grow potatoes or corn. Pumpkins sort of out on the margins, so people are sort of growing whatever they want.
Yeah.
But with a little bit of guidance, just to make sure there's not too much of any one thing, so to avoid, you know, too much lettuce or silver beetle or something.
Hmm. Well, they're very mixed gardens, aren't they?
Yeah.
And let's have a look at this one just through here. So whose is this one, Julie? I mean, what sort of person?
This one here is Jack's.
Jack, and he has.
And Jack's mustard. One of our youngest crew here. Jack's just 22. And he's been here for a few years. So what's he got in here? He's got some red cabbages. He's got some
red cabbage there.
Yeah.
Shadow, bok choy, Osaka mustard, basil, bok choy.
Perpetual spinach. Yeah.
More
chives.
And yeah. Some little spring onions, it looks like, over there. Chives? Yeah.
Chives, yeah.
Fantastic. Look how much diversity there is here. It's beautiful. With your bananas up the top on the northwest facing slope.